Good evening and welcome to the Yarra Hills Secondary College Information Session, Year 7, 2022. Before we start our presentation tonight, I would like to make an acknowledgement of country. I wish to acknowledge traditional owners of the land on which we are meeting and pay my respects to their elders past, present and emerging. I acknowledge and respect their continuing culture and the contribution that they make to the life of this city and the region. My name is Leighton O'Donnell. I'm the Campus Assistant Principal, and I'd like to welcome everyone to the presentation tonight. Firstly, I'd like to go through the school values, and we have REAP as our school values. We look at respect, endeavour, achievement, and pride, and we do that in all the work that we do. I would like to introduce the Moorabbin Campus Key Staff, College Principal Darren Trippett. We've got a Campus Principal on the Moorabbin Campus, Rachel Lynch, myself, Campus Assistant Principal, Mr. Leighton O'Donnell, Head of Junior School, Mr. Chris Gurr, Student Wellbeing Leader, Ms. Georgia Hayden, and Year 7 Coordinator, Ms. Marika Bella. You'll get the chance to hear their voices through this presentation.
Hi, it's Marika Bella, the Year 7 Coordinator at Yarra Hills Secondary College. I'm here to discuss the different types of platforms that we have at Yarra Hills Secondary College. Some of you might be familiar with Compass. Compass is a student-parent porthole. There's different levels to that, so parents and students both have a different accessibility to these things. But parents receive notifications. We have events and excursions and information and consent that happens on Compass. Financial information, so payments for excursions and other events can happen during this time, just over the app. Interim and end of semester reports are also stored on Compass, and also obviously the parent details, medical alerts, etc. is also stored and looked at via Compass. Moodle is a different platform again. This is a bit like a storage drive of all the work that students will be completing or looking at. So the homework, classwork, assessments are all stored on Moodle. So that's a bit of a hard drive for the school to have all the unit planners and all the work for the semester set so that you can have a look and follow on with your student. So how do you access Compass? By now you should have already received your login details in the post. Please contact your campus office if you've not yet received them. You can access Compass via our college website, yarrahills.vic.edu.au, and you'll just follow the links towards that and then enter the details and passwords, or you can download the Compass app and then install that and enter your details as well.
The college runs a peer support buddy program where a selection of Year 10 students are given peer support training. These selected students are then grouped with the new Year 7 cohort at a ratio of one peer support leader for every four students. Over the year, Year 7s participate in activities that are run in these groups. Your child's peer support leader will quickly become one of their go-to people in their first year at the college.
At Yarra Hills Secondary College, we have many student leadership opportunities available for Year 7s. We have the Student Representative Council, the SRC, junior school captains, we have library captains and games and club captains.
Assemblies are run at the college, and there are two types. There's campus and student-focused ones. Parents will be notified and invited to attend the campus assemblies. Presentations occur during these times from guest speakers. Students showcase their talents as well as celebrate their achievements during those times. The student-focused assemblies address operational housekeeping issues, and discussions are held during those times as well. Our school attendance and lateness and early departures and absences, it's really important that we follow a consistent process. We have an attendance officer that exists opposite the junior school office where I live, and it's important that students present to school with a written note from a parent or carer so that students can then sign in and out if it's outside of the regular beginning and ending time of the school day. Calls to the attendance officer for approval to sign in and out are also accepted, and parent carer permission can also be logged on campus for late arrivals and early departures. Now your child's at secondary school, it's important to know how you can be involved in their education. Attending Ready to Learn interviews is a great opportunity to find out more about your teachers and subjects. It gives you an opportunity to also find out how to best get your child organised and ready for the school year ahead. Helping your child with homework and establishing a homework and study routine is brilliant. It will set the pace for the following year. Having that worked out before the homework starts coming in is strongly recommended. By providing a learning space and a designated time for homework will set students up for good habits moving forward into the new year. You're invited to contribute by attending at sport events, attending award ceremonies, participating on school council, music support group, join Parents and Friends Association, where you get to participate in fundraising activities, helping with information night, college productions and other college events. So how do I join? Contact Mr. Cameron Woods and discuss it further to become involved in the school. His number's there, 9736 3650. Questions or concerns? Both students and parents, please keep communication open between yourself and our school. If there are any issues, we need to know about them straight away so we can address, rectify, or discuss issues quickly and with a satisfactory outcome. Who do you contact? Well, the best process, the first point of call, should be your child's life skills teacher. Through Compass, you'll be able to email them or you may choose to ring. Next would be the year level coordinator, Mrs. Bella, and lastly, myself, head of school, Mr. Gurr. The canteen is very popular at school and it's open daily and runs at recess and at lunchtime. Lunch orders can be placed at recess. The camp is an integral part of your child's transition to secondary education and it deliberately runs very early in the term. It's a terrific opportunity for your child to meet their new class and year level for the year, as well as form really important positive relationships with staff. Often these relationships that are formed stay with the children for the rest of their time during school. Some of the frequently asked questions about camp is it important? Well, it is important for the reasons already touched on. It gives your child to belong very early on and be part of something great. Most children are nervous about camp. What do I do? You encourage them, you normalise that they might be a bit nervous and let us know in advance if you have any concerns and we can always have a quiet chat and encourage them and put supports in place. Do children have to do all the activities? Well, they're obviously encouraged to, but if there are particular activities that students are afraid of doing, they can watch from the side. By being present and watching their peers engage the activities is really important, and we encourage that. You'll have an opportunity to list any medical or dietary needs for your child for camp, as would have happened in primary school, to that role. We run excursions, and one of the first excursions that your child will participate in early term one is a Making Connections Day. That Making Connections Day is an opportunity for all Year 7s across both campuses at Mount Evelyn and Moorabark to come together and participate in team building activities and get to know each other as a cohort that will one day be together in senior school. All Year 7 students from across the college come together and they have peer support buddies on that day as well, and they are led through activities by those groups. College sport events, swimming, athletic carnivals and cross country are all college events, so students from both campuses come together during those times. Parents are welcome to attend on those days and students will be allocated a house during term one next year. The houses that we have are the red-backed spiders, red, blue, the blue dolphins, gold, which are the eagles, and green, which are the green dragons. Extracurricular activities form a significant part of students' life in secondary education. In the first week of term one next year, your child will have an opportunity for music tryouts, where their class will go into the music room and they'll get to experiment and play a variety of different instruments to see whether or not they would like to learn an instrument at the college. We have a music expo night on Tuesday the 8th of February and a music camp on the 4th to the 6th of May. We have round robin sports, general interest activities like the production, as well as lunchtime activities and clubs that run each week. Uniform at Yarra Hills Secondary College is worn with pride, and students are encouraged each day to wear the appropriate attire. It can be purchased at Lowe's in Linlithgow, and in the event of your child being out of uniform, they need to bring a note and a pass can be given to them by their coordinator. Where a note has not been supplied, consequences follow. Purchasing the correct school shoes is really important at the get-go, as we don't want families to purchase shoes that are not in the school uniform. So to be sure of that, to be sure you are buying the right shoes, make sure that they are plain, all black, polishable school shoes, or black polishable runners, or with a small heel. No logos are permitted or colours on the shoe. The college has a sport uniform, and on the days that your child has sport, they are to bring that in their bag and get changed for the class that they have sport with, and then go back into their regular uniform. Sport shoes are only to be worn in sport classes and not in general classes. The type of sport shoe should be a cross trainer or runner and not a canvas or a Dunlop volley, as they do not provide adequate foot support. The clothing your child is to wear is to be in full uniform for all PE classes. You can't wear a blend of regular uniform and PE uniform, and you need to bring a change of clothes in a separate bag to take to class. Jewelry and makeup. Makeup must be minimal. The college allows 2 facial piercings, and these must be small, discreet clear plastic or metal piercing. Earlobe stretches are not permitted at the college. Earrings are to be no more than the size of a 5-cent piece in radius. Mobile phone and devices. In a nutshell, mobile phones should not be seen or heard during the school day. Phones are to be locked in student lockers, and if used, they will be confiscated and be collected from the office at the end of the day. Consequences will apply for repeat offenders, and phone rules apply for smartwatches as well as phones. In the event of your child needing to contact you, they need only see a student manager or myself, and we will readily make the phone available to contact home. Bell times. We encourage students to be at school by 1:45 at the latest, preferably at 1:40. A lot of socialisation happens at school, especially after lockdown, so having time to catch up with friends and chat is an important part of school life. So arriving well before the bell, the warning bell at 8:50, is recommended. And there goes one of the bells in the school day, that's what it sounds like. Period 1 starts at 9 a.m, which runs for 75 minutes. So at 10:15 a.m, period 2 commences. Students have a 35-minute recess between 11:30 and 12:05, followed by lunch between 1:20 and 1:55. Between 1:55 and 3:10 is period 4, and after that time, the school day concludes. Lockers. All students will be issued their own locker, and that will be given to them by the student management team. It's important that you buy a lock purchased only from the school, as students may forget their combinations, lose their keys, and we have a master key for all combination locks. The combination codes are also stored at the office. That way, students can be responsible for the condition of their lockers and cleanliness, and if they're having any issues with their particular lock, we can work with your child without the need to have bolt cutters, which is a terrible waste of money and time. Your child will be given a timetable, and this timetable will be able to be posted on their locker, on the inside of their locker, and we encourage students to become familiar with the room numbers that they need to attend and the materials they need for different subjects. Their timetable and schedule for each day will be also available on Compass. Organisation and preparation tips. All students will be given a diary. It's important they use it, that they write their name in it and use it as a form of communication between home and school. Students will need their diaries in the event of needing to go to the library, leave class, or move around the school for any reason. The timetable will be in your locker, as well as one to be kept at home, and we encourage families to consider colour coding books to match a colour coded timetable to help with organisation. Stationery items that can assist with organisation include a glue stick, ruler, pencil, plastic pockets. Please check with your child at the end of each term if they need anything restocked, because students can go through things very quickly. Often parents ask, how can I help my child from home with their school? We can help in a number of ways. Homework time is an important part of a child's learning when they're at home. Checking that a student diary is being correctly used in recording work needing to be done. Making sure your child has a designated quiet space that allows your child to focus. And allocating set time when they do homework. Where there is no homework, reading, revision, and finishing off classwork is very important. Limiting phone use and TV and other distractions during this time is highly advisable, and ensuring your child understands the set homework, and if difficulty exists, contact should be made with the regular teacher. Where a child comes home and does not understand the work is an opportunity for a conversation, so please contact the school. Check their homework, encourage your child to produce work to the best of their ability. And on Compass, look for at-risk notifications where teachers will post on Compass any work that has not been handed in on time. Yarra Hills Secondary College is part of the Real Schools program. That is overseen by the man pictured here, Adam Voigt. Adam supports the school in its implementation of restorative practices at the college. A short film exists next to this link that you are watching now, which will give you a greater understanding of the principles of restorative justice that are used, like in many primary schools, to resolve conflict, repair harm in a no-blame forum. Buses. All families eligible for bus travel have been contacted and paperwork is being processed. Students will be issued with a bus card and students must have this with them to travel on the bus. How does my child know which bus to catch? What happens if they miss the bus? What do I do if I'm nervous? Can my child get on and off at a different stop? Understand that your child is one of many, so please ask the question, make contact now, and contact the bus company to find out which bus number best suits you. Go on the web, the bus companies provide comprehensive maps, or alternatively, you may contact the school and we can help with you. You may choose to go on the bus route prior to the first day, so the child knows where to hop on and hop off. That may help with nerves. And in terms of getting on and off at different stops, that's completely up to you, but we encourage you and your child to consider hopping on with other students from the college, as safety in numbers does apply. Wellbeing and CSEF questions. If you have any wellbeing concerns or needs, we have a coordinator of wellbeing in Georgia Hayden. She can be contacted on 9839 8800 and she'll be more than happy to take any inquiries. There are a number of important dates that we wish to advise all students and families for next year. On the 2nd of December, we have Small School Day, which is for students that are coming from schools where there are only a few from their primary school. That gives them a chance to orientate themselves within a small group. On the 7th of December, the entire cohort of Year 7 for next year will be meeting at the school, and we have a number of exciting activities planned for that day. On the 9th of December, we have Ready to Learn interviews, where you'll have an opportunity to meet your child's teachers, some of them, as well as set goals for 2022. The Year 7 start on Monday, the 31st of January, on their own to explore the school. And then the entire cohort of the college joins us on the 1st of February. Orientation Day this year is on Tuesday, the 7th of December, and runs from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. This exciting day for our new students starts with them meeting us at the basketball courts next to the front office. Staff will assist students in finding their home groups, and each student will be given their own timetable to follow for the day. Lockers will be assigned to each student, and some of their Year 7 teachers for next year will be ready to assist with this. Students are to bring their own lunch, while the canteen will also be open on that day. Online Ready to Learn interviews are scheduled for Thursday, December the 9th. The purpose of these meetings are for parents, students and teachers to come together and answer any questions about the school, share information and establish some individual learning goals ready for the new school year in 2022. Please refer families to your transition pack that was posted to you to book an interview time on campus for this event. And please contact the school office if you need any assistance with this. Some of the frequently asked questions about day one for Year 7 next year, which falls on the 31st of January, is what will the day look like? Well, as we ease students into secondary education, we will have staff in the yard greeting students and signposting them where to go. Students will assemble outside the C building, where there will be witches' hats with each home group labelled. Students will join their home group at the beginning of each period, and their teachers will greet them there and take them to their designated classes. Over time, students will orientate themselves around the school and learn how to make their way to their classrooms independently. But we do that in the first week or so. Students need not pack absolutely everything, their entire book list on day one. What they need is the books that they write in and their pens, and teachers will be understanding if over a series of days students bring in their belongings. They'll be given lockers and an opportunity to meet new friends, as well as play sport and have recreation out in the yard when they're not in classes. Students can catch the bus home on the first day, so this gives them a chance to begin the day with only themselves and Year 11 and 12 senior students present, which makes the day easier because there's less traffic. Please join us on Facebook. Look us up, Yarra Hills Secondary College, and that's a terrific way of keeping across events that are happening in the college. Finally, if you have any further questions or wish to discuss any concerns, big or small, please contact the school on 9839 8800 and identify yourself as a parent or carer that has a child starting in Year 7 in 2022, and you'll be directed to the best staff member depending on the area of concern or the question you may have. Please work in partnership with us. Don't be afraid to pick up the phone. No problem is too big or too small that we're not prepared to hear from. We're looking forward to seeing your child on Small Schools Day or on the big Grade 6 Orientation Day that's scheduled for later in the year. Look forward to meeting your child and you in person in the not too distant future. Thank you.